I'm Reverend Vicki Elder, and we welcome you all virtually and in person to this inclusive celebration of light on this Northern Hemisphere winter solstice, when we begin to emerge from this longest, darkest time of the year. Since ancient times, this drama around the return of the actual physical light that sustains us has served as the basis for myth and ritual, symbolizing perennial new life, the birth of gods, and the center of hope. In honor of this solstice and the transformation our nation and world are engaged in, we begin with this solstice song. We began this service in 2005 in response to the great change and chaos that was happening in our world, and in recognition that those of us alive during this time are part of an epic-level transformation, a great turning. As often occurs with great change, much of humanity has become engulfed in a consciousness of fear, desperately trying to hang on to the past, not recognizing that change is the only constant, and control has always been an illusion. It is clear that our current potentially lethal quandary cannot be resolved at the same level of consciousness that created it. An evolutionary leap is needed and is inevitable. And we who have been born into this time and place are the chosen ones. Whether we remember choosing to participate or not, the role of transformer is now ours. As daunting as this dilemma appears, we know that the mysterious forces that have guided earthly events over millennia through the sequence of crisis moments at each stage of its development have not suddenly collapsed under the great volume of human affairs. From the beginning, the ever-unfolding, ever-expanding, upward progressive movement of life that many of us call God set the design that continues to shape the course of the heavens, light our sun, and form our earth. This same design that created the continents, the seas, and the atmosphere, awakened life in the primordial cell, brought into being the unnumbered variety of living creatures, ultimately evolving into modern humanity, has successfully guided us through the turbulent millennia of evolution. Theory suggests that some 200,000 years ago, our human evolution leapt from physical adaptations to the realm of consciousness. While we largely retain the physical bodies and brains of our prehistoric ancestors, our minds and cultures have continued to evolve from awareness to self-awareness, to meta-awareness. We are now awakening to the realization that we are expressions of the same consciousness that is the creative force behind all of creation. No longer just subjects of evolution past, we now understand that we are instruments through which the evolutionary forces express. And as we grow into what it means to be conscious agents in this process of evolution, we find ourselves awed and inspired by the enormous opportunity and responsibility we now have to directly participate in the evolution of all life. The significance of the challenge before us lies in the magnitude of change required. We cannot simply mitigate the symptoms of our current reality, but rather we must co-create and birth a new dream, one that transcends not only national and religious limitations, but also our species' isolation from the rest of creation. A new dream dependent upon a new story that acknowledges that life happens from the inside out. Our stories are where everything begins in our human affairs. The narrative of how things came to be and have evolved determines how we understand and thus how we imagine our future going forward. So in 2005, wanting to create a bridge from what is to what is to be, we here at Unity of Monterey Bay began to share a new sacred story to discover ourselves within, a story that integrates rather than negates our modern understanding of the universe, while also acknowledging the eternal and sacred mysteries that still exist. A story that hails from a mountaintop, where we can look back to honor the journey already traveled and look forward to envision our future. And a story that honors the diverse sacred traditions of the world and the deep wisdom that each brings to the whole, all helping to usher in a new awakening, with flickers of hope born in an increasing awareness of our world's inherent interdependence and the importance of each of our voices and actions. But the work has only begun. As Gandhi said, we must be the change we want to see. By continually choosing love over fear and hope over despair, what a grand and glorious time to be alive. So let us begin. Imagine we are gathered here tonight on this Northern Hemisphere winter solstice in the year 2500. And imagine that we are aware of similar gatherings taking place in churches, synagogues, temples, mosques, and sacred circles all around the world, as humanity celebrates the world's spiritual reawakening that occurred in the early years of the 21st century. Perhaps it would go something like this.
Sing the joy of all the nations. Sing of joy in every land. Sing with joyous exultation through our hearts and with our hands. Let our spirits gather freely. Let our joyous light be true. Deep within we feel the meaning. Joy to all anew. Sing of joy with all our voices. Sing of joy in all our days. Sing of joy, celebration. Watch the heart to find a way. Fear no clouds and fear no darkness. Let the joy be stronger still. Bring forth your invitation. Joy is life for us to fill.
Tonight we come together to celebrate the great spiritual awakening and the covenant of light that transformed our human journey by creating a new sacred story that united the world's people and reestablished the earth as sacred. During the 20th century, the ways of the modern came to dominate the earth, bringing great gifts, but also great challenges. Science, technology, and freedom expanded exponentially, but also unleashed our human arrogance, shifting our focus from truth to facts, and now to a post-factual world. The earth became a resource to exploit, facts faded to opinions, and the truth underlying our sacred stories were lost and forgotten. By the start of the second millennium, the world had become fragmented and embroiled in conflict on many levels. Climate change, caused by the pollution of technology and rampant consumerism, had reached dire proportions. Communications technology was making the world smaller, but also promoting conspiracies and fear. The canyon between the haves and the have-nots was growing ever larger, with greed and corruption dominating the free market. And people, many feeling left behind, attempted to find certainty in the midst of an ever-changing world, falling into reactionary tribal responses of fundamentalism, nationalism, and terrorism, often guised in righteous religious trappings, but which further divided rather than revealing a healing truth. Humanity needed a new sacred story to find ourselves in, a story that would educate us, a story that would heal, guide, discipline, and unify us, a story that would renew our human participation in the grand unfolding liturgy of the universe. When world circumstances finally reached an existential crisis, a world gathering of wise prophets convened. These leaders, from diverse backgrounds and disciplines of spiritual, scientific, and social realms, came together to discern new answers to the world's crises. Most importantly, they understood that each field had essential pieces of the puzzle, and only by working together could we heal the earth and unite humanity. The gathering participants agreed to listen generously, without judgment, to share authentically, with integrity, and to seek the highest and the best from each of the traditions present, with open hearts and open minds. They set an intention to step beyond their known worlds, to engage in one another's, and to co-create together an unprecedented vision of possibility for the world's future. The circle opened with this story.
Test. A pious rabbi named Isaac once lived in Krakow. He was very poor. One night, as he slept on the dirt floor of his hovel, he had a dream which told him to go to Prague, where under the bridge that led to the royal castle, he could unearth a great treasure. He set out for Prague the very next day, and after many days of walking, he found the bridge that led to the castle. But the bridge was guarded day and night, so the rabbi walked back and forth, awaiting a moment when the bridge might be unwatched, so that he might dig for his treasure. The captain of the guard finally became curious and approached him, saying, "You have been walking back and forth for days. Have you lost something?" At this, the rabbi innocently related his tale. The captain, a modern secular man, replied, "You have worn out all that shoe leather on account of a dream?" "I, too, had a dream, three times. He told me to go down to the town of Krakow and find a rabbi, Isaac," that was him, "and then dig in his dirt floor behind his stove in the middle of his room, and there I would find a great treasure. But dreams are only silly superstitions. Go home, old man. Stop wasting your time." The rabbi immediately understood and promptly returned home and dug underneath the heart of his hearth, where the warmth of his own being lay. And there he unearthed a treasure which put an end to his poverty.
At that story's conclusion, the wise prophets nodded in realization at its seeming paradoxical, yet important truths. First, it taught us that the treasure which can put an end to our spiritual poverty lies not in another country, but can be found within the heart of our own heart, in the center of our own tradition, if we dig deeply. Equally important, however, is the second message. It often requires a pious journey to a distant land and encounters with strangers of other beliefs and faiths to come to know ourselves and discover the treasure that is within. The prophets each chose a direction on the sacred wheel that most closely embraced their own tradition. The directions on the wheel symbolized both the value of distinctions and the sacredness of the whole. Intentionally shifting energy from fear to love, from fragmentation to wholeness, the sacred was reclaimed and the healing of the world began. A covenant of the light was formed, a commitment to work together in recognition that the wisdom perspectives of all were necessary to address the myriad of human crises in which the world had become enmeshed.
Dreamer, but I'm not the only one. imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood of man. Imagine all the someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one.
This was only the beginning. As with all truth, it planted a seed, which would continue to yield fruit only if tended. Within this covenant of the light, a new human story of unity was imagined. One that celebrated human diversity while also recognizing our inherent interdependence and shared destiny with one another and the earth. Tonight we're doing our part to tend to this truth, joining with people all around the world on this winter solstice eve to remember and recommit to the great awakening of the 21st century. And through story and song, honor the sacred gifts of each of the four directions of the sacred wheel of life. As our pageant unfolds, there will be song and story interspersed to engage our spirit and imagination in this transformative journey.
We're co-creators building a new world. Co-creators building a new world. We're co-creators building a new world. Co-creators building a new world. With our hands healing all the earth. With our hearts healing all the earth. With our minds healing all the earth. All of life, no sacred rebirth. We're co-creators building a new world. Co-creators building a new world. We're co-creators building a new world. Co-creators building a new world. With our hearts healing all the earth. With our minds healing all the earth. All of life, no sacred rebirth. We're co-creators building a new world. Co-creators building a new world. Co-creators building a new world. Co-creators building a new
world. Good evening. I speak on behalf of the people of the South, custodians of the most ancient traditions that appear the most powerless in modern terms. The ancient traditions were called primal, indigenous, pagan, earth-based. Yes, they are. For millennia, the ancient ones lived in harmony with the earth, the Americas, in Africa, and down under, by the original instructions. But the wisdom of the ancient traditions, of the original instructions, have been subjugated to Western ways. You see, the original instructions are not ideas. Neither are they mandates like the Ten Commandments or the laws of other spiritual traditions. The ancient traditions, the original instructions, are reality. They're called the way of things. They are not of the mind, but of the spirit. They cannot be fully described or explained, but must be experienced. The wise ones, our ancient fathers and ancient mothers, learned through deep listening to the songs of life, to the grasses growing on earth, to the rains in the sky, the mountains and the winds that blow across our faces, the rivers and the oceans, the winged ones and the four-legged ones. Each sings a song of wisdom and of truth that we can learn from the harmony of life, reminding us that we are not the weavers of the web of life, but merely strands within that webbing. And what we do to the web, we do to ourselves and to our children. You see, the world stopped listening to these sacred songs and forgot the original instructions. Technology spawned ecological ignorance and ignorance, and the world has lost its way. Through the spirit, through the gift of storytelling and the language of the spirit of the earth, we offer a guide back home.
It started when we lost our drums. We got too busy one month and didn't bother with them. One month led to another, and soon they were forgotten. We were silenced except for our tongues and our brains. Without the drums, we forgot how to listen. We became out of step with the rhythms of the earth. Our hearts and minds grew crusty with lack of use. Our power declined, and we lost our ability to communicate. Our bodies forgot they had spirits. Our spirits forgot they had bodies. We started believing that we were machines, so we built other machines to pass the time. Surrounded by machines, we thought they were our brothers. We had no sisters, but we didn't know it mattered. We began to live according to the machines' knowing. We thought they knew more than we did. We forgot how to breathe. We struggled to be happy and became confused about love. We tried to kill or stifle anyone who didn't act like the machines. As we treated our bodies like machines, they began to break. We grew old, but we did not die. We just divided and multiplied until we filled up the whole planet. We began to suffocate. Then one day, we found our drums under a discarded pile. At first, we thought they were toys. We used them with our sound machines. But gradually, their power seeped into the backs of our memories. One by one, we learned again how to use the drums. We returned to our circles. We resumed the beating. The rhythms began intertwining again. We remembered how to listen. Our hearts awoke and began loving of their own accord without the brain to organize and confuse. The brains took a much-needed rest. The machines fell into a cold, brittle sleep. Our spirits began to touch each other and the earth again. We found our sisters, and our bodies woke up and remembered how to die. With the return of death, our powers came back in full. We used our tears and the blood of the sisters to heal the damage we had done when we thought we were machines. The damage was immense and almost irreversible. But we had found the drums just in time. It took many years and some new rhythms added to the old. But now the earth is green again, and we breathe deeply as we walk the sacred path.
A sacred place, a secret meeting place, love is there. In the silence, where every color blends and every rainbow ends, good is. And all your dreams unfold, love is there. Peace is there. Truth is there.
I represent the people of the East traditions that have bloomed in the great cultures of the Orient and include Hindu, Buddhist, Tao, and Confucian. We locate the sacred within the silence, that sacred place where words and activity come to a full stop, allowing for self-reflection and divine revelation. The noise of modern living entrances people. Without silence, we forget how to know ourselves. We become caught in the vicious cycle of consumerism and addictions as we fruitlessly seek to define ourselves by external trappings. Our egos, grounded in fear, come to dominate our souls. Silence stands outside the world of profit and utility. It cannot be exploited for profit. You cannot get anything out of it. It is unproductive. Therefore, it is regarded as useless. Yet, there is more help and healing in silence than in all useful things. I light the candle of the lotus, representing the gifts of self-reflection and humility, to balance the human voice and power that have come to dominate our world. In the silence, we can hear truth's whisper, which awakens our minds from illusions and prejudices to invite mindful living.
are the people of the West and are called the people of the book, the peoples of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, who share Abraham's recognition of one God, the all-encompassing spirit engaged with the human family and actively concerned in human destiny. We locate this sacred in our personal and communal relationship with God and our co-creational responsibility for the future. Although our core focus on maintaining connection with the divine is exemplified by the mystic branches of each of our traditions, we find that increasing environmental, economic, and geopolitical concerns can combine to drag our everyday consciousness down into the dualistic material world that perceives differences in others as fearful and dangerous. Our challenge is to remember that to be God's chosen people is to accept the responsibility to center ourselves in the divine and act as conduits of God's love towards everyone we meet. Together, we bring the sacred gifts of faith and transforming love to the world.
The Hebrew tradition's great faith in one God has had a lasting and compelling influence on the evolution of Western thought. Defining the sacred in a God of love and justice, intimately involved with humanity, seeded the concept of hope and purposeful activity, holding the potential for improvement. The wisdom of the Jewish sages teaches that effort is its own reward. We are here to do, and through doing, to learn, and through learning, to know, and through knowing, to experience wonder, and through wonder, to attain wisdom, and through wisdom, to find simplicity, and through simplicity to give attention, and through attention to see what needs to be done. The Hebrew tradition also introduced the idea of sacred rest, the Sabbath or Shabbat, a time when the world stands still and we cease all activity to breathe into the now sacred moment and realize the presence of God. In the Jewish tradition, Shabbat is celebrated every week, beginning at sunset on Friday and ending at sundown on Saturday, in keeping with creation story in Genesis. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that he had done, and he rested. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work that he had done in creation. Tonight we light a candle in honor of the ancient wisdom the Hebrew tradition has gifted the world.
Christian tradition grew from the life of Jesus of Nazareth, a Jewish prophet. His true message is best understood when embraced within its sacred Hebrew context. In the tradition of Hebrew prophets before him, Jesus challenged his spirit to go beyond their fears and rituals, to reclaim the spirit of the law as a means to know God. Jesus calls us to radical, inclusive love and the universal justice that grows from it. Love and justice liberate us from the illusion of separation, creating a sacred world community. Tonight, we light a candle in celebration of Christmas, the birth of Jesus Christ consciousness, and the realization of God's love expressing through humanity into the world.
The youngest and fastest growing of the Abraham traditions is Islam, which literally means the peace that comes from submission of the will of Allah, Allah being the Arabic word for God. Like Judaism and Christianity, Islam is the most authentically expressed when separated from geopolitical control and influence. Its foundational message, our willing submission to God's will, underlies all true faith and is the ultimate evidence of our trust in God, the good, whose will inherently is the highest good for all of creation. It is just a surrender that a return to the sacred will initiate as we mature from willful children into responsible stewards of creation. Tonight we light this candle for peace of faith-filled surrender.
In all forms, thy love in all beings, thy light is in all forms, thy love in all beings. Ooh, Allah, ooh, Allah, ooh, Allah, ooh.
The light is in all forms,
thy love in all beings, thy light is in all forms, thy love in all beings. Ooh, Allah, ooh, Allah, ooh, Allah.
Finally, I represent the people of the North who locate the sacred in knowledge. We are the people of science. We have recently been positioned in opposition to spirituality, but in fact, we have deep roots that suggest one can best know God by understanding creation. Copernicus, Galileo, Einstein, and Teilhard de Chardin are but a few who honored God through the study of science. Though there was a brief time that some thought scientific knowledge would resolve all of life's mysteries, maturity has revealed that science does better to inform the spiritual journey rather than to replace it, and that the great mysteries are beyond physical accounting. Knowledge can, however, enlighten superstitions and prejudices with informed explanations and understanding. This allows for increased tolerance and reduced fear. But objective facts alone do not reveal truth. Factual knowledge can best be used to inform, not direct or control, our sacred quest for meaning, significance, and transcendence. Questions of truth must include the transcendental realm. The gifts of mind and heart become balanced once again. We light this candle in honor of the sacred gift of curiosity, that we can embrace knowledge to inform our quest for truth while honoring the great mystery.
Thank you.
Having received these sacred gifts from these rich and diverse traditions, we will now share in a time of contemplation and reflection, opening our hearts and minds to listen for the wisdom that will guide us forward in our sacred journey. Representing the people of the South, who locate the sacred in nature, who bring us the gift of story in the language of spirit to guide us back home. It begins to move towards you and your center. It grows slowly in size, becoming a steadier flame as it grows. And as it slowly approaches, you become aware of a second, small, flickering flame coming from the east. This flame represents the people of the east, who locate the sacred within this very silence, and who bring to the sacred center of your divine nature the gifts of self-reflection and humility. So now there are two flickering flames moving towards you. You notice a third small flickering flame in the distance to the west of your center. This flame comes from the people of the West, who locate the sacred in relationships with God, relationships both personal and communal. These people bring to humanity the gift of sacred community. This flame begins to grow in size and brightness as it too begins to move toward you. Now, with three tongues of sacred flame growing slowly as they move toward you, you notice a fourth flickering flame in the distance to the north. This flame is being brought to your center by the people of the north. These people locate the sacred in knowledge, bringing with them the gift of curiosity, and bear their sacred candlelight to the center of the universe, which is located at your sacred center. You watch as the four flickering tongues of flame approach, and you notice that as they come nearer to you, they also come nearer to one another. Soon they are joined in one brightly burning source of heat and light and power, comfort, and love. Focus your vision, your attention, and your thoughts on this combined sacred flame as you spend the next few moments in the silence. now warmed, illuminated, empowered, and comforted, loved and embraced by the sacred flame that is your source and your sacred center, I invite you to gradually begin to return your attention to this time and this place. As you do so, visualize this flame as something that is always with you, always enlightening your spiritual path. Know that this sacred light and all it represents, both your personal center and the center of the universe, where an eternal peace that passes human understanding resides, are with you in every moment and in every breath, in everything that you think, say, and do. And so it is.
I'd like to invite the ushers to come forward, please. Minor adjustment. Before we symbolize the celebration of light with our candle lighting ceremony, we invite you to join in this opportunity to support our vision, to commit to it with our time, talent, and treasure, donating with a special holiday offering. Please join me in our offertory blessing. Awakening to the sacred light within that expands all that I am and all that I give, I offer this gift of myself to expand the light, love, peace, and joy I wish to see in the world.
So let's give a hand for all our readers and this beautiful music before we do our candle lighting. And I'm going to invite the ushers to start passing out the candles, but begin up here with the choir, making sure they all get them. So we're going to conclude our celebration with a candle lighting ritual that symbolizes the light that shines in and through each and every one of us as we discover and align with that which is sacred in our lives. Candles are a perfect metaphor for spirituality. When we use something physical, it is diminished, but spiritual things increase with use. When we share sacred wisdom, we become wiser. When we give love, we become more loving. When we offer a spiritual gift, the recipient gains and we lose nothing. Similarly, when we use one candle to light another, the original candle, let me get one too. I just want to be sure I get a candle too. Okay. Similarly, when we use one candle to light another, the original candle remains bright. Its light is not diminished. On the contrary, the two candles together enhance each other's brightness and increase the light. The ushers are passing out our candles, each with a blessing wrapped around it that will open together in a moment. The blessings are here are to remind you of this night and the light that you are, the hope that we have kindled, and the miracle seeds we have been planting through this new co-created story. Celebrating our diversity while recognizing our inherent interdependence and unity. So while you're all getting your candles, I'm going to do a little of instruction about how we light candles as they go down the aisle. The person whose candle is lit keeps it upright, and the person who wants the light from it turns their candle and then holds it upright for the next person so we don't drip wax on each other or anywhere. So. So does everybody have a candle now? All right, so now let's all, I have a tradition that I don't share what my blessing is. I just keep it to myself, but that's up to you. So we can all read our blessing. And now I'm going to invite the two ushers to come forward. And you can light your candles from the Christ candle in the middle there. No, you can hold it up right. Okay, so if your candle is lit, you hold it upright, and the ushers are going to go down the aisles and light the choir in person there too, Linda. Thank you. On earth and good will to all, this is the time. As we invite this candlelight to awaken the light within each of us and commit to it expressing through us and as us into the world, I invite you to join me in this solstice prayer. May we all be encircled. Is it up there? May we all be encircled by the magic of, oh wait, you can do the second part, I'm going to do the first part. May we all be encircled by the magic of fire, by the warmth of the light, by the love of God, and by the flame of our friendship with one another. May we find hope in the lights we have kindled on this sacred night, representing the awakening of humanity into new consciousness. Please join me in affirming. In the heart of every person on this earth burns the spark of luminous goodness. May we who have celebrated this winter solstice by our lives and service, by our prayers and love, call forth from one another the light and the love that lives in each and every heart, and co-create a webwork of love, peace, and justice as we embody the transforming light of the world. Amen. Why don't we lift the lights up and just look around. And so now, when you're ready, I'm going to invite you to take the truth of this flame of hope and unity into your heart, extinguishing the physical flame, which is only a symbol of the true light that lives in and expresses in and as you. Remember, we are the light of the world. God's calling. So just as a reminder, we'll be holding our magical, mystical, metaphysical Christmas story on Sunday, December 24th at 10 a.m. and our New Year's Day Burning Bowl on Monday, January 1st at 10 a.m. It's a great way to start the new year off. And I invite you all to join us downstairs for our potluck dessert buffet and following our closing circle with our prayer for protection and peace song. So let's make a circle. I didn't know you were going to stay. I don't know. I love seeing a circle that fills, goes the entire outside of the sanctuary. This is awesome. And so as we hold our planet and all the people of the world in our hearts and minds and send special healing, peaceful love and energy to the Middle East, we join in our prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. I am light. The love of God enfolds us. I am love. The power of God protects us. I am power. The presence of God watches over us. I am presence. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the that was meant to be, with God as creator, family all are we. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony.
Yeah, that was fun.